Hello, thank you very much for coming out on this rather dreary Sunday afternoon. It's our pleasure really to be with you, and I thought as we go along in the programme today, I'll introduce each section. So whether you know the music and you're really familiar with it, or whether you're really new to this, hopefully you'll know what's going on at any one moment in time. I kind of subtitled this this recital "Snapshots of a Romance," because, you know, yes, tomorrow is Valentine's Day, if you didn't know, and with all of, whether they're arias or songs, all of them have this feeling or talking, commenting on love. But I deliberately called it snapshots because anyone who has ever been involved in a romance knows that the path of true love never runs smoothly. And so particularly the opera arias, I'm going to start with one opera aria from Verdi's Otello after Shakespeare's play. It almost kind of show us the dark side of love and what happens when love goes wrong. And I think, you know, since the subtitle of the series is classical music done differently, I thought, well, hey, here's love done differently, or done actually more realistically. So the first aria we're going to perform for you comes at the end of Verdi's Otello. And Desdemona, who is Otello's wife, has had a pretty tough time throughout the whole of the opera. She doesn't quite know what's going on with Otello, but something's very wrong. And she knows it's so wrong that this may well be her last night on earth. And, you know, she's not quite a sort of battered wife or anything like that, but it's gotten to crisis point, her marriage to Otello. And so she's in her bedchamber with her servant, Emilia, and she's oddly sort of recalling an old song that her mum used to sing, or, you know, a servant of her mother used to sing, who fell in love with someone and then was abandoned, and she sang this song called the Willow Song, Salce. You'll hear that a lot in the first half. Salce, salce, that's what it means, willow. And it's a song of mourning, really. And it's kind of called to mind because she's very sad, obviously, in herself about the state of her marriage, but also pretty scared about what might happen next, or what she has a presentment that something really bad is going to happen to her next. Just as Emilia is leaving, she says this very big, impassioned farewell to, you know, addio. It means not just goodbye, but farewell forever. And then she starts saying her prayers, the Ave Maria. And as she prays to the Virgin Mary, she asks the Virgin Mary to pray for us, to prega per noi, particularly for herself, but also to pray for those in power and those who have no power at all. So it's a very moving scene before we get into the final scene with Otello. And that's the way of love sometimes, isn't it? Sometimes it's hard and it's scary. But don't worry, friends, it does get better. in this recital, anyway, you know, this, it isn't all doom and gloom, and I'll explain as we go along, but this is the Willow Song, Salce, and the Ave Maria from Verdi's Otello.
Madre aveva chiome. Io questa sera ho la memoria piena di quella cantilena. fra le spose e le vergini sei tu, sia benedetta il frutto, benedetta di tue materne viscere.
Now, the next four songs we're going to perform for you are actually some of my favourites. Unknown to Simon, I call them the sexy French songs because I think they are quite sexy. They are all about love, mainly images in nature. So the first one, Les Papillons, the butterflies, it's really asking these butterflies whether I can borrow their wings to fly to the lips of my beloved, say French, to the lips of my beloved. Le Colibri, the hummingbird, has got the same sort of vibe, if you like, the idea of you know, sort of dying with the first kiss of your beloved. So it's all very good for Valentine's Day. You know, Le Rossignol de Lilila, nightingale of the lilies, it really, it's quite nostalgic. I'm talking about this nightingale, or the song of the nightingale being, or the echo of old Aprils, old springs, presumably when I was with my beloved and all was well and good. But it's a very beautiful song. My favourite, though, is, and for any of you who listen to recordings of French songs, I would highly recommend Didier Henry singing Les Cygnes. Beautiful rendition. But I'm just going to give you a quick rundown on the translation, because I think the poetry is very beautiful. Les Cygnes, the swans, and he says, your soul is a lake of love on which my desires are swans. See how they go around, how they there furrow their lines. Travellers, intrepid travellers, they have open wings. Nothing is unknown to them of the blue waves on green islands. Noisy and stately, some are of a whiteness beyond compare. And those are desires born in the perfumes by an Indian, a Bengal sun. The others, silent and black, have an air of mystery. And they are desires born during the night, where everything is asleep on earth. Without number are these birds, which your soul is seeing a hatching. How many are already on the waters, and how many are still to be born? Your soul is a lake of love on which my desires are swans. See how they go around. See how they go around your soul. Isn't that great? So I hope you enjoy these four sexy French songs. The first two are by Chausson, and the second two are by Arne.
Si me voulez prêter le zèle.
so sorry.
Thank you.
you very much. I'm just going to get a bit of water. So this final aria, before we take a bit of a break, a bit of an interval, which I think some will appreciate more than others, is from Benjamin Britten's Peter Grimes. Now, ladies, I speak to ladies because I'm a lady, but I'm sure it's the same for men. You know when you've fallen in love with a wrong'un, and you've gotten a bit of a bad feeling in your gut, and then you're presented with the proof. Well, this is exactly what's happening here. Ellen Orford is sort of loosely sort of engaged, or certainly involved with Peter Grimes, but there has always been this question about how he treats his child apprentice, who helps him with the boat, and at this stage, that child has gone missing, and Ellen is, you know, a teacher, but she also embroiders, she sews. And this aria is famously called the embroidery aria because she says, look, they find the child's jumper, and it's a jumper that she's embroidered. She's embroidered an anchor on the chest of the jumper. And it is proof that her something terrible has happened to this child, and it's quite possible that her husband-to-be, as it were, Peter Grimes, is at least partly responsible for this. So it's, honestly, it does get better in the second half. And so this embroidery aria, she starts off talking about embroidery, and then comes the refrain, now my embroidery affords the clue whose meaning we avoid. And it really is a sort of turning point for her as well as a turning point in the opera. But it's beautifully kind of written by Benjamin Britten, as always. And I hope, in spite of the subject matter, I hope you enjoy this aria. It's the embroidery aria.
Thank you.
Thank you, first of all, for staying to the second half. We were put off by our critic in the first half. The next set of songs we're going to perform for you this afternoon are by Puccini. Now, Puccini is mainly known as an opera composer, and a lot of folk don't even know that he wrote songs, but the surprising thing is that a lot of the tunes, a lot of the famous tunes that we know from his operas actually first started as songs, and never want to waste a good idea, he decided to use them in some of his subsequent operas. And so I'm hoping that if you have heard one or two of Puccini's operas, that you'll recognize some of the tunes in these songs. Morire is really a kind of reflective song. What is death like? Is it like this? Is it like this? Is it la simplicità? Is it sort of simplicity, quiet, or is it perhaps a sort of shining life of new dreams over and above old tired dreams? But that particular song turns up in Puccini's La Rondine. If you've ever seen or heard bits from La Rondine, it's an Act One aria that the tenor sings. And then we go on to Sole e Amore, the Sun and Love. It's a song actually which Puccini almost wrote on the back of an envelope sort of idea. He was doing an interview for a magazine called the Paganini, and they asked him to write a little song that they could put into the magazine or into the newspaper, and he wrote this. If you know La Bohème, which is currently running at ENO, if you haven't been to La Bohème, but if you know La Bohème, you'll recognise this from the Act Three sort of quartet, the ensemble, and the words of the song are really about how the sun knocks on your window in the morning to wake you up, whereas love knocks on the door of your heart to sort of get you going, get you engaging with the person who, think about pensa chi t'ama, think about the one who loves you. Terra e Mare is another one that reminds me of La Rondine in Act Three. There's this big sort of seascape that Puccini writes in the orchestral score, and it's about the earth, terra, and mare, the sea. The singer is dreaming of the sounds of the sea, and this sort of wakes up and continues to dream about the voice of the sea, which is a long way away. And then the final two, El Uccellino and Sogno d'Or, are actually lullabies, really. The first one is very sweet. El Uccellino, the bird, is chirping somewhere in a tree and jumping from branch to branch, and you can hear in the piano little chirps from the little bird, and lulling this baby to sleep and saying fall asleep in your mother's arms. And then Sogno d'Or is straight out of Act Two of Puccini's La Rondine. There's a big ensemble that all the soloists and the chorus sing, really extolling the virtues of love. But here, it's a golden dream, a sogno d'or. It's a mother lulling her baby to sleep and saying that the angels are preparing wonderful things for this child. So I hope you enjoy these five songs by Puccini, and we're going to start off with Morire after I've had a quick drink. thank you. I hope you really enjoyed them. Puccini is a composer very close to my heart, as is the next composer, Strauss, Richard Strauss. The three songs that we've chosen to perform for you this afternoon obviously have love at the centre of them. The first one is called Einerlei. It has a dual meaning. Here it means kind of sameness or uniformity, and the singer's saying you've got your mouth is the same, but your kisses are always new. And it goes on to say, Ordu liebes Einerlei, you dear sameness. How much sort of diversity there is in you. So it's a beautiful love song. And then Aller Seelen, which is probably one of the more famous Strauss songs, actually has the word Einerlei in it. Und wenn man sieht, it says, give me your hand, and if someone sees it, das ist mir einerlei. That's like saying, das ist mir egal, I don't care. It's all the same to me. But Aller Seelen is actually an interesting song because it starts off talking to someone who is actually here or seemingly here. And then towards the end of the song, we realize that actually it's All Souls Day. And I, as the singer, are talking to my beloved who has passed. But for one day of the year, the dead are frei, they're free and very present to me as if they were alive. And then the final song, Ständchen, is a song about seduction. The singer saying, look, come out, no one, it's wonderful out here, come out. And then towards the middle of the song, sort of says, And while you're at it, just sit a bit closer, and then they have a few kisses, what have you. But it's a beautiful, you'll hear things like the nightingale flying about, obviously, because it's a love song. So I hope you enjoy these three love songs by Strauss, starting with Einerlei.
Thank you.
Actually, I forgot to have a bit of a shout out for my partner in crime, Simon, before those Strauss, the beautiful kind of preludes and postludes that Strauss writes so beautifully. Yeah. So our final item today is from Verdi's opera Luisa Miller, and where we started a bit somberly, we end with a bit of a party, because in Verdi's Luisa Miller, it's Luisa's birthday, but she's also very excited about seeing her beloved Rodolfo, who, you know, obviously he's got another name because it's opera. This is her kind of act one opening aria, where she's saying, you know, our love was meant to be, you know, that God ordained us to be together, that whole kind of first love. She's only about sort of 16, and, you know, that whole excitement of first love, that's why it's so kind of frothy. Yeah, I love it. It's a role that I've sung, but it's a really, I thought it would be a really nice way to finish off this afternoon together with you. Thank you so much for your attention and for your enjoyment of the music that we make. It really is wonderful to be back, as it were. So thank you so much.
Più calda di virtù non mai.
prepared an encore. Some of you will know if you've sort of followed the last bit of my career. Last year, where are we now? 2002. So year before last, Simon and I recorded an album of songs by a Londoner called Samuel Coleridge Taylor, who lived in sort of Victorian times. And we kind of dodged lockdown, tier restrictions and all of that, and sort of got that recorded and released it last year. And we're both very honoured that it's been nominated for a BBC Magazine Award. We're really proud of having brought a lot of these unknown songs to light. I think there are 16 world premieres on the album alone. So we thought we'd perform for you the song that is at the end of the album. It's a beautiful, another love song, really. But it's interesting, considering that it was written in a sort of Victorian time, I think it was written at just at the turn of the century, it does sound rather 1930s. You'll see what I mean once we actually start performing it. But I hope you enjoy this song, and if you do, do look up Coleridge Taylor and a lot of his work. He's a Brit and one to be proud of, really. I think you really enjoy a lot of his music. It's very accessible. So I hope you enjoy this song, Life and Death.